Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Becky, and on this platform, I talk about natural hair, beauty, and life in general. So if you're new here, welcome. And if you've been here before, thank you so much for being my D's.
So today, I'm going to be sharing with you guys how I take care of my baby sister's hair. Yeah. I'm going to be doing on the hair in another color. Yeah, I know it's a very painful hairstyle. Yeah, it kind of bring some old memories for me. Yeah, in other colors, hairstyles I used to do when I was still in my primary school days, and I still actually do it, but it's a very painful hairstyle, so it wasn't easy when I was a kid. I do it, but I'm not consistent with it. My kid sister is going to have a taste of it.
Before we get into the video, let's learn a little bit about cornrows, which falls in the same family as Inabakala, I think so.
Inabakala braids, they all fall in the same family. They're all protective style. Enough of the talking, let's get right into the video. The origin of braid can be traced back 500 years in African culture to 3500 BC. They were very popular among women, says him. Braiding started in Africa with the Himba people of Namibia, says Peace. These people have been braiding their hair for centuries. In many African tribes, braiding hairstyles were a unique way to identify each tribe. Braid patterns and hairstyles were an indication of a person's tribe, age, marital status, wealth, power, and religion. Braiding was and is a social art. Because of the amount of time it can take, people often would take the time to socialize. It began with the elders braiding their children, then the children would watch and learn from them. Younger children would start practicing on each other and eventually learn the traditional styles. I actually learned how to braid in school when I was in primary school, I think, college year. This tradition of bonding was carried on for generations and quickly made its way across the world. It was around 1900 when braid became most popular around the world. Almost all women, children, and most men in some way had their hair braided. In relation to time, period, Peace created Africa with cornrows in 3500 BC. Egypt with Afro box braid in 3100 BC, Greece with halo braid in the 1st century, Native American with pigtail braids in the 5th century, Europe with the crown braid from 1066 to 1485, China with staircase from 1644 to 1912, the Caribbean with modern cornrows in the 1970s. And the internet, of course, with braid tutorial becoming especially popular in 2005 with YouTube launch. According to Sim, cornrows with beads were popular in the 1970s and box braid gained popularity in the 1990s. In my opinion, braid will never be out of practice. They are always going to be fashionable because they are practical and chic, says Saviano. Expression and styles have changed, but braiding patterns have remained the same, says he. In today's culture, braids are worn and praised in many different ways. Men and women who would not have worn them previously now embrace them. Women are approaching the braiding style in different ways. From clean lines to braids that are organic and messy, women are taking on a fresh approach to coolness. I think it's safe to say this style has maintained a historical legacy that is here to stay. Now that we know a little bit about braid, which is also a family of Inabakala, let's get right into the video. So I'm going to be sharing with you guys how I make my Inabakala. I hope you guys enjoy it. Please don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with your friends and loved ones. Turn on your notifications so you won't miss every time I post a new video. Thanks so much for having my back.
D'ici ou d'ailleurs, nous sommes des enfants d'Afrique, même si le ciel tombait, luttons pour la paix. Kondiamu Africa, mon laïnyan. Manejamu Africa, moi sonyo natangé.